Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can check each number of matrix whether it is palindrome or not. Before starting, you can note my information. You can follow or subscribe my YouTube channel through the URL youtube.com/sanjaygupta_techschool. You can download my programming app TechMS, which is available on Google Play. Now I am going to implement the solution of this problem with the help of C programming. So first I am including a header file stdio.h. Then I am implementing main function. Inside main I am declaring a 2D array. Then I, j variables, then n, t, s. These variables are declared for calculation purpose. Now with the help of printf I am going to display the message enter elements on console. To receive elements from user, I am applying nested loops. So here, I loop will be representing row indexes and J loop will be representing column indexes. With the help of scanf, all elements will be received from user and will be assigned into A matrix. After completion of reading operation, now I have to apply the logical part. So for that purpose, again I am implementing nested loop. Now inside this loop, I am assigning value of aij into n. So now I have to check whether the value available inside n variable is palindrome or not. So I have initialized s with 0. Now first I am calculating reverse of n. So for that purpose, I am applying the condition n greater than 0. Inside this condition, I have to apply the logic so that I can reverse n. So first statement is t equals to n modulus 10, then s equals to s into 10 plus t, then n equals to n by 10. With the help of this logic, reverse of n will be available inside s. So this logic is for reverse. Now after this reverse operation, I have to check s with n, but I can't use n here because after completion of while loop, value of n will be 0. So in place of n, I can use aij because n is containing the value which is available inside aij. So I can directly use aij in place of n. So if the reverse which is available in s is equals to the original number which is available inside aij, then we can say number is palindrome. So I can print %d is palindrome, comma s, or you can write aij also here. So s and aij both will be containing same value, so you can use any particular notation, whether aij or s here. So this is the complete logic. After completion of all loops, I am writing return 0. So with this logic, I am going to display check whether each number which is available inside matrix is palindrome or not. Now I am going to execute this code. So you can see I am entering different values. Now you can see the output 11, 33, 44, 77, 55, 66. All these numbers are prime. Remaining 12, 56, 45. These are not prime numbers. So palindrome numbers. So six numbers are palindrome and remaining three numbers are not palindrome because their reverse is different from original. So this way I have checked whether the number which is stored inside matrix is palindrome or not. I hope you have understood the logic well. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can follow or subscribe my YouTube channel through the URL youtube.com/sanjaygupta_techschool. You can download my programming app TechMS, which is available on Google Play. Thank you for watching this video.